Because Becca, where is the ANC today? It is in bed with the party of white monopoly capital, ETA. This is because of President Zuma's move with creating uMkhonto weSizwe, which has forced the ANC to either go left or right. The ANC has gone right to where it actually was. Abantu manje can no longer argue that the ANC is not the party of reaction. ANC is a party of sellouts. How can the ANC go into debt with the Democratic Alliance, a party that represents white monopoly capital and those who have stolen our land? So President Zuma has clarified that position. Abantu don't have confused anymore because of uMkhonto weSizwe has come into the fray and reduced the vote of the ANC, which is a correct thing. What the ANC should have done was to come to the revolutionary path and team up with uMkhonto weSizwe and the EFF, and would have gotten two-third majority to change the constitution to bring about change. It did not do so. The ANC has gone to Stellenbosch. It is President Zuma's move to create uMkhonto weSizwe, to create that dialectical tension, to clarify our politics. Today our politics are here. He genuinely apa, he revolution that. President Zuma is not just stopped there. In Parliament we have something called the Progressive Caucus. Anything about it genuinely led by the DA ideologically to make sure that there's no transformation, to make sure that uMntomnyama uhlala ehlupheka. GNU uBaba Zuma has moved to create the Progressive Caucus in Parliament, where revolutionary parties are now forced to work together. TFF is there, ATM is there, uMkhonto weSizwe is the leader of the Progressive Caucus. The CCC is also there. So comrades, all I'm saying is that the move by President Zuma to create uMkhonto weSizwe has clarified South African politics. I equal and you could keep better enemy. Umlungu ngamnikeza ama votes without that being seen as selling out. Pambili ngamalala pambili. There's also a few other examples where President Zuma has shown himself to be very smart. President Zuma concocted, as I say, the notion of the clever black. The clever black. You see, it's system yabelu. As it does, using the ANC as the bodyguard, nathi individuals, it's system yabelu ngena inside the candidate. Bekuma nomlungu nyana obhizi la ekhana ngaphakathi. Mawuthi ucabanga black athi no no no, move this other direction. Ama clever blacks lawo, abantu bamnyama ngaphandle, abamhlophe ngaphakathi. President Zuma is the one who identified them as a problem for a revolutionary process. No still be gonna so same people who are among 9 words. What if they are black? However, their aspirations are white. Therefore, they are not black, they are non-white. Because they would have wanted to be white otherwise. But they can't be white because of their skin color. Therefore, they are non-white. uMalcolm X said the same thing. Abantu bamnyama bonke are oppressed and enslaved, but the master comes, chooses a few amongst them, brings them in the home of the master, give them leftover food, give them clothes that he doesn't want anymore. And labo, I'm a house negro, but born up close to the master. And they defend the interests of the master. And then they are field Negroes. Laba akutoma ngama corrupt. South Africa mawu field Negro kuzo to corrupt. Baza to mawulandela President Zuma. You are doing so because you are corrupt. Those who are vilified, those who are arrested for no reason, just like President Zuma, those are field Negroes. Now, the field Negro, unlike the house Negro, Yasini lo xa umaster egula uthi naye hey siyakula. Xa umaster elambile uthi hey silambile. When the house of the master is on fire, hey, he does everything, even including his life, to stop the fire. The field Negro, on the other hand, hates the master. And when there is a fire to the house of the master, the field Negro prays to his God, God, that a big wind must come so that that house must burn down. That is the field Negro. That is what we are. Field Negroes. That is why I think I fully the constitution. You are my house Negro. We're ANC. uMkhonto weSizwe is very clear. This constitution, the Roman Dutch law, mele siyikhiphe, sifake constitution yabantu. Comrade, one of the biggest problems is that abelungu baphethe umhlaba and bakhuselwa the constitution, because each constitution in South Africa yaxoxwa yi-ANC kababa uMandela. Uma ufuna umhlaba mele uthende kumlungu. Imagine. It is there in section 25 of the constitution. If we want our land back, we must buy it. Now uMkhonto weSizwe is clear. We must get that two-third majority. We must work very hard. That is why in 2026, we must win all these metros. On the next elections, we must win the two-third majority and then show the ANC that we can amend the constitution. And we will amend the constitution. In fact, we'll get rid of this constitution to bring about an African-centered constitution, which will start by saying the land belonged to black people, land belonged to Africans, land was stolen by whites from its rightful owners. Our constitution will be true. That is the clarity that is needed ideologically. And uMkhonto weSizwe, comrade, using this Zumaism, has adopted Pan-Africanism as ideology. There's no umhlangano omkhulu where we discussed some of the founding documents, the MK, the document on theory and tactics defines the ideological construct of uMkhonto weSizwe as Pan-Africanist. In South Africa, siyazi ukuthi Pan-Africanism izwe ngobaba uSobukwe. And siyazi ukuthi ubaba uSobukwe was so powerful. You know, comrades, abelungu kept Sobukwe in jail through Sobukwe clause, which meant every year abelungu besale parliament bathi akaphume ejele. Because Kulma, remember that time, parliament was higher than even the courts. Yeah. So abelungu, every year they had the Sobukwe clause and they revived it to say uSobukwe akaphumi etrongweni. Not only that, even when you go to Robben Island today, uSobukwe bamenzele indlu yakhe special, away from other prisoners. Because bebesaba ukuthi uSobukwe uzoba teacher lama prisoner about Pan-Africanism and indaba yomhlaba ibe phambili. That's why they isolated him. Now uMkhonto weSizwe goes there and takes the ideology of Pan-Africanism and says that we are going to be Pan-Africanists in pursuit of our struggle.